Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. Today we're going to learn how to use a DSLR camera as a source on the Linux version of OBS by just using a USB cable to connect the camera to the computer and by installing 2 to 3 free and open source packages. Yes, that's right, that's without the need to use a cam link or other similar capture cards or devices. And as always, all the necessary links are included on the description down below. Let's go! Before we do anything, it would be good to check if our camera is supported by the package first. We can do that by searching for gphoto2. gphoto2 is a command line front end to libgphoto2, which is a library that can be used by applications to access various digital cameras, while on the other hand, v4l2 loopback is a module that allows users to create virtual video devices. Normal v4l2 applications will read these devices as if they were ordinary video devices. The video will not be read from a capture card, but instead, it is generated by another application. V4L is short for Video for Linux, by the way. It's a collection of device drivers and an API for supporting real-time video capture on Linux systems. Alright, let's click on this link. Here are all the currently supported cameras. Quite a lot, eh?
Nice.
Okay, since my camera is a Canon EOS 200D, that's what I'm going to search for. And there it is. Now, in order for us to install both gphoto2 and v4l2 loopback, we're going to need to use the terminal. And of course, the way to install it would depend on your chosen distro. Since I'm using an Arch derivative one, I'm going to use Pacman. Alright, let's launch the terminal. Enter gphoto2 and v4l2 loopback-dkms. Alright, before I forget, make sure to have ffmpeg installed as well. It's already in my system, so I would not include it. Enter the password. There we go. After installing, let's connect our camera to the computer by using the USB cable. Right here, the USB port. Hold up. And here we go. Connected. Okay. Then, to make sure that our camera is being detected, let's enter v4l2-ctl --list-devices. There it is, our device's name is Video0. It just showed up right away because I've set it up earlier, so let's remove it by entering sudo rmmod v4l2 loopback. The rmmod command is used to remove a module from the kernel. We can use either rmmod or modprobe-r to remove modules. Let's see if it's still being detected. Cannot open device /dev/video0. Now let's set it up again by entering sudo modprobe v4l2 loopback, where the modprobe command is used to add or remove official Linux kernel modules. Okay, let's check again. There it is. To check if there are other cameras connected or is saved on the kernel, let's enter ls for the list command, followed by /dev/video*. /dev is a directory that contains special or device files on Linux systems. The asterisk that follows video means 0 or more characters. When used with the ls command, the shell finds all file names inside the current directory starting with 0 and passes them to the ls command. Since this is the only camera that I have connected to the computer, it only shows video 0 or the device name. To check and see if our connected camera is working with the packages installed, let's enter gphoto2, the name of the package, followed by the command capture image and download. If everything works as intended, the image would be saved to the home folder. Just like that. And because the camera is on raw image capture mode, besides the JPEG image, it also saved the CR2 or Canon's RAW or log file. Let's take a look. See that? Now that that's done and we have confirmed that it's indeed working, let's enter the commands needed for us to be able to use the camera as source on OBS. This is going to be quite long, okay? So, let's enter gphoto2, the name of the program, followed by stdout or standout what? Followed by stdout or standard output, which is used to text output of any command you type in the terminal, and then that output is stored in the stdout or standard output stream. Set config to set the configuration. Liveviewsize equals 0 for large. I think the liveviewsize's value would depend on the camera. You can enter gphoto2 get config liveviewsize to get the liveviewsize options for your camera. Followed by capture movie. It's the command for previewing the stream. Followed by pipe, this vertical bar looking thing. to pipe GPhoto to standard output and config to ffmpeg for live viewing. Followed by vcodec rawvideo to set ffmpeg to read the pipe data from GPhoto 2 and to set the video codec to raw. Pix underscore fmt yuv for 20p to set the pixel format to yuv for 20p. Threads 0 to set how many threads ffmpeg would use. fv4l2 to set the format to v4l2, followed by s:v1920x1080 to set the dimensions. R25 to set the frame rate. I made a mistake here. It should have been 30, I think, but the captured video was still saved as
60 FPS
for some reason, so I don't know. And finally, /dev/video0 to set ffmpeg to use our camera because this is the camera's device name. Okay, so before we enter the commands, let's switch the camera to video capture mode. There we have it. Now let's set it up as source on OBS. Add a scene and let's name it Canon DSLR. Add the source, select video capture device, let's name it EOS 200D, click OK. There we go. Set the resolution to 1080p, frame rate to 30fps, and click OK. So it's really cool that we can do this on Linux by just using a USB cable and installing two packages, but there are a few caveats. As you can see on OBS, we only have a single audio source. And that is the desktop. Because, according to the devs, they have not implemented or don't have a feature that can also capture sound from the camera's microphone. And of course, the commands that we have used do not contain anything related to audio. A few more things to keep in mind is that when we use the camera as source on OBS to record videos, the footage is saved directly to our computer and not to the camera's SD card. In fact, the camera is not even recording because GPhoto 2 is only using the camera's live view. Also, if we want to adjust, let's say, the ISO, the zoom level, the shutter speed, the focus, or anything related to adjustments, we'd have to adjust them manually on the camera itself. Or at least, that's the only way I can do it. Not sure how it is on other distros. Another thing to note is that recording videos using the camera itself while it is used by OBS as source is not possible, which is not a big deal really. Even if we try to record the camera itself, it doesn't work. See? Nothing. I've also noticed that I needed to re-enter the commands to be able to use the camera as source on OBS every time I turn off the camera. Like the system just forgets about it. So to sort of lessen the steps that I needed to do, I've made a super simple bash script that contains the commands that needed to be entered to the terminal to use the camera as source on OBS. And of course, I have made it into an executable desktop shortcut. So now, I just have to turn on the camera, click on the desktop shortcut, launch OBS, and it's good to go. Here's an example on how it would look like on a typical streaming video. Just think of the system monitor as a game and the OBS video as the streamer's facecam. Well, that's about it. Just wanted to share a cool thing that I've learned recently. Thanks for watching and see you again next week. Maybe.